This is Sand. I'm Talal. Let's talk. We're meeting today with Emmanuel Corel, one of my dearest favorite people in the world. Many of you might recognize him from the launch party that we had for This is Sand, whom he DJ'd for. A lot of you probably know him from all the wonderful parties he throws in Paris, from BLT, where we met, 13, 12 years ago? Ghost, Liquid Smoke. More importantly, besides DJing, he also is a sound design engineer. He's played for parties such as Cartier, Chanel, Dior, Saint Laurent, Loewe, Jean-Baptiste Valli, to name a few. He always does the music for Alexis Mabille, the couture shows. He's been working for MoMA. So what many of you do not know is Emmanuel's love for jewelry, and he has just launched his line, Emmanuel Corel Paris. And let's start there, Emmanuel. Tell us, when did this love and fixation with jewelry start?
A few years ago. It was when I'm starting to think about it, because my family have a lot of jewelry and jewelers, you know, in South of France. Mm-hmm. And I'm starting to make an art school and after fashion school. So I think, you know, the way to start to freelance to help, you know, some brand, and I collaborate with them, and also I create my own jewelry brand during a few years, men and women collection, and I'm starting again to go back to, you know, like unisex piece, and for the new generation with you know, like
yeah, where did you study the jewelry?
Yeah, to S-Mode 1 year, and after I went to Studio Berceau. Mm-hmm. And during my last year in Studio Berceau, different brand, you know, ask for like a new person collaborating freelance who directly to the office with them, young person, young talent or something. And I was contacted by a group and after big brands. And I made jewelry for them, but in another way, I'm starting to have my own collection of jewels. So I create my my first collection, unisex, men and women. And now, after a few years, I go back to some pieces of archive for create again. You know, like if a bestseller was there, you know, it was really. It was really cool to adapt, you know, 15 years ago, a new model with a new version of metal, or maybe some colors of pearls or different fabrics.
What's the reason that, what inspired you to start the brand now?
Ah, yeah. I'm just realized now, with this period, you know, like to stay at home in quarantine, you know, like, I don't know, don't do something like to travel or to walk, you know, beside with music or parties or something. You know, I have time to make again all the digital to connect, you know, the people to an e-shop or the new version of the collection. So it was very easy during this time, yeah, with the help of my friends to create the page, the website. Every colors, you know, declines on the website too, and yeah, it was the best period to making it. Maybe yeah, if we are in a normal period, I don't have the time for that, and to be very, you know, in attempt to this page.
Amazing. I also wanted to get back into kind of, you're from Marseille. Marseille is a melting pot. Your background is also melange. You've got Tunisian, you've got Italian in you. It's all that hot Mediterranean beach, sand, weather. How do you feel all that kind of inspires your collection?
Yes, all these elements inspire me for sure, because my family is from South of France too, and origin, you know, from Mediterranean Sea. So, yeah, you know, one of the collection is called the Corniche. Corniche is one of the parts of Marseille, very close to the sea. Mm-hmm. And it's very sunny collection. But every time, you know, it's unisex, you know, yeah, men and women can wear it, you know, it's very easy, fabric are easy, but, you know, in we are in a new period to to save the material and to save, you know, the stones and everything, to not, you know, pollution. And my part, it's to keep this
sustainability,
to keep these accessories from many years, and the fabrics don't move. It's not, you know, like one season and you throw up, you know. It's it's the less price than the jewelry, but it's haute fantasy. It's great because, you know, you can wear it and it's a more classical, but with modern side inside.
And it is the way of the future. Sustainability is where we need to go, and, you know, as a unity to move further in the world and benefit each other and the world. So that is a great substance to have a point of view on. Do you remember the first piece you ever made?
Yeah.
What was it?
It was for my own collection. It was a piece for a magazine. I think it was Numéro magazine.
Uh-huh.
You know, it was, you know, like Creole, but inside have a lot of French. French of velvet, and it was very cool because it was only one asymmetrical, the model inside the magazine was cool, and the look was great to wear with that one. So I remember that one for sure, a big one. Yeah.
And what is the favorite piece of jewelry that you own? I know you love your jewelry. Anyone who knows you knows you've got quite a collection. What is the most favorite piece that's so close to your heart? Can you pick one?
It's the first one. It was a model of family jewelry, you know, but inspired me because I declined, you know, the gold to serve to my collection after that, and because the shape and. The shape was very old. I imagine, you know, to cut, you know, this shape to add in modernity now.
Mm-hmm.
And it's very old piece from family. Yeah. And also my mother, you know, wear a lot of, before most of the time, you know, the collection and, you know, in the street and party and or restaurants, you know, she wear. And I see on her if it's good to sell or to have, you know, a new influence on it.
Yeah. I also wanted to ask, maybe this is a little bit early days, you did mention you collaborated with designers before. I was gonna say, if you have your choice or your dream designer that you would like to collaborate and do jewelry for, whether it's a collaboration for their line or whatnot, is there anyone that sticks to
you
mind?
You know, I'm thinking about it, you know, when we will finish this period, I think most of the people want to be connected again, so I have my own love for designer I admire, and some of my friends also, and I really want to work with them if they really want to make collaboration. But I think now you know, you can mix jewels with sneakers or architecture or design, so maybe a designer from an architect is great, you know, for
any specific name
space,
name you could give us. Any specific designer you would like to? Would be like the dream?
In fashion, I know them, but because they are my friends, it's, you know, like, it's a surprise for this. But for the designer or architect, I love a lot, you know. I love a lot of new designer. I love Matthias Kiss. I love, you know, of course, Adid, but, you know, by so many shapes, you know, and they inspire me, for sure. They inspire me because the shape of the jewel, so maybe, like, you know, the knot inside or something like that, was very connected to something like an architect.
Yeah. Amazing. I think that brings us to the end.
Okay.
That was easy. How are you spending the rest of your day?
No, I'm very happy. Thank you so much.
So you're still in Paris. You're going to go to Marseille in a few days.
In 2 days, yeah.
Brilliant, my love. Well, thank you so much for taking the time and joining us.
Thank you, my love, too.
It's such a pleasure. Sorry for all the mishaps with the recording. Let's see if anything
recorded. Okay, sure. You know, it's every time now, everywhere.
And fingers crossed, I'll see what happens. So, now we're cut recording. Now we could talk.
Yes.
What else is going on?